Hi guys, and welcome to an all-new Dinner with Ardawen. Today, I'm gonna make pork in soy sauce a la Ardawen. And this is actually a recipe I learned from my mother, and she learned it from an Indian lady. But still, let's call it pork in soy sauce a la Ardawen. So, this is just a preparation status. This is actually the evening before I'm going to cook the actual meal. And you could also do it the morning before you're going to actually cook it. But be sure that you're doing it a couple of hours ahead of time. We start up with some pork, and again I really want to stress, like I did previous time, if you have the money for it, if you have the possibility for it, buy meat from animals that had a better life than in the big mass stables. I know it costs a little bit extra, but it's really better for the animals. And like for me, for example, I just don't eat meat every day so that I can buy meat like this. It's really quite more expensive. It's not better tasting, it's not worse tasting. It tastes exactly the same. It's just a little bit friendly for animals. So please make a mental note of it. So I'm going to do this in my thing here, and then I'm going to add some soy sauce in it, or ketjap manis, and I just add enough to make sure that my meat is all wet. Giggity. Just not too much, not too little. When we are actually cooking, let me try to show you guys here. When we're actually cooking the dinner, we're gonna add more to it. But for now, this is what we're gonna add. So that's that, and now we're gonna add some onions. And some fresh garlic. So, and now before I'm going to add the spices, let me first quickly wash my hands. So now I'm just gonna add some pepper, a bit of salt, not too much. I actually rather use a little bit more garlic than salt, and I know garlic makes your breath smell, but it's just a lot healthier for you than garlic. I mean, for your kidneys, for your bloodstream, for everything, you know, so just eat it if you're not going somewhere for the next few days. So a little bit Djahé. You can be firm with that. It's just gives them an extra spice, and of course the Djinten again. And just like last time, I'm doing it on taste. I'm not actually sure how much I'm adding, but you can see here that, no, you can't see it, but And then again, we're mixing it around really good. Just so that all the spices are well spread everywhere. There. I'm washing my hands again. And then we're basically done for the night. Just let me find something to put it in that I can close off. So that my refrigerator isn't going to smell like onions. And that's it for tonight. And we'll be back tomorrow with how to make the rest of the dinner. And we're back. So, as you remember yesterday, we marinated this meat. I know it looks gross now, but I'm telling you, it's gonna taste awesome. So, I'm gonna take a pan here. In it is a little bit of butter. I did overdo it a little bit with the butter, but that's okay, it's oil of butter. So what we're gonna do now is wait until the butter is ready. Done hissing. So what we're gonna do now is add a little bit more onions and garlic. Again, this is a matter of taste. The red stuff you see is actually tomato juice, tomato, because that we're gonna add that later, but I already opened the tins. So now that this is nice and brown, make sure you don't make it doesn't stick. We're going to add the meat of yesterday. I know what you're thinking. You're probably thinking, ew. So what we want now is that the meat gets well done. And while we're waiting for that, you can open the tins, what I already did for you guys. Tomato juice. And don't forget to occasionally stir the pan. Stir your dish so that it's
not sticking to the pan. Well, you might think this is way too much meat, and you're probably right. But I'm a meat eater, I love meat, so that's why I did that.
Oh.
And the meat is done. Well, as you can see. So I lowered the fire. In the meantime, I also prepared some rice, because we're gonna eat this with rice. Now, well, this is, of course, this isn't the dish. So now we're gonna continue by adding a few tomato juice, not juice. Juiced tomatoes, just let's keep it at juiced tomatoes. Purée. Quite a bit. Don't be scared to use too much. So I'm now adding just adding a little bit of water, clean out the tins, but I can also do it with soy sauce or a ketjap manis, as long as I use as many of the tomato juice as possible. And since I'm gonna use soy sauce anyway, so now stir it again so that it's mixed. So now I'm gonna add a little bit more soy sauce. Stir it again, just so that it gets a nice brown color, like this. And in the meantime, don't forget to watch your rice. Okay, so now we're going to make it on taste. So I'm taking a little spoon here. And now I'm going to decide what I'm going to add. So I'm going to add a little bit more Djahé. Quite a bit of Djinten. And just make it until it's the way you want it to be. This, and basically now you're done. All you have to do is let it boil a little while. And now we're going to add a little secret ingredient to end it up, and that's sherry. Now, I just bought the cheapest butter I could find, so don't really care about that. I bought dry, and you really need just a little bit, just for the taste. Also, you'll probably know this because you're not a dumbass. Oh, let me lower the temperature of the rice. You probably know this because you're not a dumbass, but don't be afraid for the alcohol. The alcohol will vaporize, and it's just the taste of the sherry that will remain. So just a little bit. This should be enough. And then mix it around a little bit. Dead. Perfect. So I'm just gonna do this so that the alcohol vaporizes, and now I'm going to wait for the rice to be done, and then I can have dinner. Will you have this dinner with me? Let me know if you tried it out and what you thought of it. So that's it for this time. I hope you could get a grasp of how to make this pork and soy sauce a la ardawen. One thing I forgot to mention yesterday is that when you can't eat pork, I did make this dish once with beef, and it didn't taste as good as this will taste. However, it still tastes okay, and it's still eatable, and I didn't have to change any other things of the recipe but the pork. So, and again, just flavor it up to your own taste, that you say, where you say, alright, this kind of tastes nice. So that's it for today, and I hope you enjoyed it, and will enjoy it, and I'll see you all next time.